Eurovision funk and hip hop and a variety of other forms of music group with Mick Jones, a significant contribution. And as well, he is a filmmaker of substantial note. And so we have documentaries such as the funk movie from 1978. We'll be looking at the world in the best way of the world. Tonight at the Grain Social, one on the skinheads and another one on the punk attitude, which I really liked. It. Fascinating history, which he takes in both New York and London into it. So, with that as an introduction, this is again just a thrill, and let's please welcome Mr. Don Letts.
Thank you.
Funny enough, a lot of people look at that riot and think it was a race riot.
Nothing could be further from the truth. It wasn't a black and white thing, it was a Roman right thing. And Joe took inspiration from that. He saw the brothers, you know, he get pissed off, he did something about it. And that's what he's saying in White in Soul White Right.
Yeah.
We need to do something too. We need to get proactive.
And do you think that that actually took hold? I mean, I think one of the things that's interesting as we introduced it today, this whole notion of punk in your documentary on the punk attitude, do you think that it was genuinely a political movement, or was it, I was taken by the title of your documentary, Punk Attitude? Would we derive from this more of an attitude, or do you think there was truly a political motivation?
Listen, when the punk rock kicked off, right? I mean, half of these kids were like 14, 15, 16, they couldn't fucking spell the word politics. But it was a politic nevertheless, but maybe we're not such a big P. A little P was very much about personal politics. It was about empowerment, freedom, and individuality. Some people, particularly Joe, were able to deal with the big P politics and put it in a more global